You know, on the channel, I frequently say that anxiety is not our fault. And not only is anxiety not our fault, the conditioning that we've received throughout our life is not our fault. It's just something that we received, right? The cards that we were dealt. But the behaviors and the patterns that come out of our conditioning and the anxiety that we experience still can hurt the people that we care about most and still can hurt ourselves, right? Disconnect us from ourselves. And so the unpopular conversation and the uncomfortable conversation is that although our anxiety is not our fault, it is our responsibility. And so the idea, the experience of something called radical responsibility can actually give us wind in our sails, a sense of empowerment in who we are and how we can show up to the world in a much more vivacious, fulfilling, and grounded way. Now, what I mean by that is an example from my own life, my recent relationship. When my girlfriend would ask me to do something or would share her needs with me or her wants with me for just a way that she wanted the relationship to enhance or how she wanted it to look and feel, my most frequent reaction would be to shut down a little bit because I felt anxious, and to avoid, to disconnect, also known as avoidant attachment style, if you're familiar with the attachment styles. And when I did that, you can imagine it created a little bit of an issue because every time that I did that, we would disconnect more. The more that we disconnected, the more that that gave rise to other issues to come up within our relationship because we weren't connecting. And that was an issue. And not only was that an issue in the relationship, but then with my relationship with myself, as I'd be highly critical for feeling the way that I felt, and then I'd get caught in some of those loops that you're probably already familiar with in my own mind, my own head, my own body, those self-critical loops. But what begins to create a shift here, at least for me, right? What began to create a shift for me is when those experiences, the same experiences of my girlfriend at the time, asking me for what she wanted or what she needed within the relationship, and my inability at that time to share what I needed or what I wanted, which gave rise to my own anxiety, which gave rise to these avoidant tendencies, whenever those things would come up, my new attempt, my new approach would be, okay, I feel this anxiety rising. I feel this trigger happening. This moment right now is an opportunity to get 1% better. I'm going to take full responsibility for the fact that this is one of my patterns that could be destructive to the people that I love most, including myself. And I'm going to accept it. I'm going to love it. I'm going to recognize that it is here. I'm going to take full responsibility for it. And so when that happened, when I owned that part of myself instead of rejected it or criticized it, it gave me the spaciousness to show up to those conversations, knowing that I had these parts of myself and still doing my best to show up to whatever she was asking, her needs, her wants, in a way where I was able to be at least 1%, 2% better in my presence in connecting instead of avoiding. Right? And that 2% better in connecting instead of avoiding, it gave rise to 2% more connection with her, It gave 2% more connection with myself. And so this taking full responsibility for my own patterns actually gave me a sense of empowerment, because now I viewed those moments, any moment when a trigger came up, as an opportunity for me to show up in a brighter way, both with myself first, number one, and then number two, with the person that was standing in front of me that I most likely cared deeply about. And so time after time, this, you know, it builds and it builds and it builds. And so that, you know, wind in our sail becomes even stronger. And a quote that I really like by Tony Robbins really sums this up. And it is, life happens for us, not to us. And so what we can often do, what I can find myself often doing, better now than I was in the past, for sure, is when these parts of myself come up, I don't immediately fall into criticizing myself for having them, right? I don't immediately take the whip out and say, I can't believe you're feeling anxious. And then on top of my anxiety that I was already feeling, I would whip myself and I'd feel double the anxiety, right? You might be able to relate with that. And so what ended up happening in this radical responsibility is acceptance and almost not just ownership, but a deep love for the parts of myself that in the past I didn't love as much because they would cause me pain, aka anxiety. But once I started to love them, once I started to take full responsibility for them, it was easier for me to feel them and show up to the person that I was in conversation with or going through something with. And that ultimately has led to more connection with myself. And it's led to more connection with the people that I care so deeply about. And we all have these things. We all have these things. So, you know, you and I could be sitting here talking about my previous girlfriend as if my previous girlfriend didn't have her things. But she has her things too. Everybody has their things, right? So it's not like we're alone going through this journey. It's just you and I having this conversation about, you know, this thing that only you and I have. Everybody has it, even if they're not talking about it. And so we get to shift our experience of it based on, do we want to take full ownership for this thing and begin to form a new relationship with this thing, take that full responsibility for this thing, or not, right? And the beautiful thing is that we get to have that decision. So maybe two questions to wrap this up, right? Our number one, where do we find ourselves being... where do we find these triggers coming up for us? Number one. Number two, how might we be able to change our relationship to it? AKA, instead of criticizing ourselves for having the patterns that we have, the conditionings that we have, the anxieties that we have, how can we shift our relationship to it in the sense of, oh, this is a thing that I have. Let me begin to love it in a different way. Let me begin to become curious about it in a different way. And that could open up some room to grow and feel smooth within ourselves. And then number three, throwing a third question in here, is what might that open up for us? What might that open up for us? And you don't have to have these answers, you know, bada bing, bada boom out right now, but just something that we could put in our consciousness to let those answers come up. Maybe journal on them later, maybe go for a walk and let them come up and just see what happens. And then when you're ready, or if you want to, or if you don't want to, it's okay too, but you could maybe drop part of your experience of this down below in the comments and ask a question or a comment so that not just you and I could have a conversation on it, but the other people who we're getting to have this conversation with, they might get to learn from your experience or from your question. And then, right, we're really embodying that essence of let's evolve together. Because chances are, what you're experiencing, what I'm experiencing, what somebody else is experiencing, we're all, you know, kind of experiencing some of the same things for sure. All right. So feel free to drop some things down below. If you want to keep it private, you can hit me up on my Instagram, or we can have a live one-on-one conversation. You can find me through my website. But otherwise, just thanks for being here. Thanks for being willing to have these conversations, so that we could just open up to more of exactly who we are at our core, right? And as we do that, allowing a lot more love to come through. And that makes the world a better place for everybody. So much love to you. I'll look forward to seeing you in the comments down below or in the next video. Let's keep evolving together. Ciao.